Butler Countians turned out to Woodbury Saturday afternoon for the annual Art and Music on the Green, marking the opening day of the Green River Museum and Butler County Park. Artisans of basketweaving, tinsmithing, wool spinning, painting, and glassblowing were on hand to demonstrate their methods and wares. Music was also provided as museum volunteers talked with visitors about ongoing renovations to the 1913 Superintendent's Home and exhibits at the 1912 Superintendent's Office, now used as the Butler County Museum. The banner spoke with volunteer director Tommy Hines about the efforts behind the transformation of the former headquarters for Green River Navigation.
Okay, Tommy, we're here today at the Green River Museum. Tell us a little bit about the event that's going on here today.
For the last couple of years, we've had an opening event to kind of inaugurate the season opening here at the museum, and we call it Arts and Music on the Green. So not only do we have local artisans, but we have local musicians here that are performing, some good regional food, and of course the buildings are open to the public too.
Now Tommy, we're in the superintendent's office building here on the old core property. Tell everyone a little bit about this building and when it was renovated and the purpose it serves today.
All right. The building that we're in right now, the superintendent's office, was built about 1912, and it served as the headquarters of the Green River. It's a very important building because this was the main office for all of navigation on the Green River for a number of years. It also became a residence after that, and finally the county was able to acquire the building. Today, we use the building as our principal museum. The exhibits in here all talk about Butler County history, a variety of things from the Green River itself to right now there's an exhibit on the 1872 courthouse. A lot of George Dabb's photographs are here. So it's the principal museum with rotating exhibits, changing things that all relate to Butler County's history.
Now, there's an ongoing renovation project at the 1913 constructed home of the superintendent's home. Tell us a little bit about that project and where it stands right now.
The superintendent's residence is the second building that we've undertaken as far as restoration is concerned, and last year we finished the second level and outfitted all the bedrooms with the furniture of the period, and this year our project is to get the downstairs portion renovated. So today, of course, we're opening the upstairs and part of the downstairs, and we'll continue to work on that little by little and have it all open hopefully by the end of this year.
Now, how are these projects being completed? Your funding and that sort of thing, how's that coming about?
We receive money from contributions. We try to make as much money as we can from events like today. Private contributions probably is the biggest resource for us right now. The county helps us in a nice way too each year. So that's kind of how we do it. We don't have a lot of funds, so we have to do things in baby steps.
Beth, can you tell me how you first got interested in basket making and bottoming chairs?
Well, Scott and I have been married for 32 years now, and when we first got married, we moved to Allen County, and we were thinking about, you know, how we would make our living and build a life, and so we checked a book out from the public library and really learned about splitting out white oak from there, and we had watched a little TV show, Roy Underhill, the Woodwright Shop, on public television, and so we decided to try it, and we did. And shortly after that, we met Ollie and Lustle Childress in Park City and really learned what we know about white oak and the Kentucky tradition from them. And we just feel really honored that, you know, that we had that opportunity, because the Childresses, Ollie and Lustle, are both gone now, and I don't know, it's just wonderful.
The other side the same way. Now what I'll do is I'll use one of these forming stakes. This is called a blowhorn. Because of its conical shape, I'll make things like coffee pots, like the one you see over here, or the little tankard. That's what that's for. And then the smaller end is used for things like handles. And I'll use my mallet and just...
Oh,
way it's tapered, sometimes I'll have to roll it around the other way and just kind of work it to get the shape that I want. And then all I have left to do is solder the handle on it. And there's the finished product.
The Green River Museum is open from noon until 4 p.m. Saturdays throughout the coming season. There is no admission for the museum and home tours. However, donations are appreciated. Several exhibits highlight the history of Butler County. The current centerpiece exhibit at the museum are items related to the 1872 courthouse. Artifacts include a railing from the jury box and two original chairs from the courtroom, as well as the salvage window from the building, which was raised in the late 1970s.